We hear more and more often that electric transport is the future and the gasoline engines are out of pace now. To tell the truth, I haven't taken serious such statements. But today we'll review the electric bike that made me change my opinion. Why? Stay tuned, it's going to be interesting. Hi guys, as usual it's me, just an off-screen voice, and you're watching Review Machines. Today we are visiting our friends. They have a small business of turning regular bikes and motorcycles to electric versions. By the way, nowadays it already makes sense, because batteries and electric motors are becoming better and better every day. If you remember, just 10 years ago, electric transport was not able to impress anyone. But today I was greatly impressed by this bike. Now you will see how it may surprise you. And moreover, we will make a battle of this electric bike with regular gasoline enduro bikes, but it's a bit later, and now the author of the project will tell us few words about the bike. The main advantages: it's very durable and noiseless gears that doesn't need any maintenance. Then there are no any liquids here. Now it's a real gadget. All you need to do is to charge the battery and go for a ride. That is why we do these modifications with bikes. And you can ask those guys with regular bikes how often they repair their bikes and how costly it is. Well, as you can see, we have a bike Yamaha YZ250 that was transformed in electric version. The engine, fuel tank, exhaust, all this stuff was dismantled and the battery and electric motor were installed. The motor is made in the USA, it has 45 kW of power. There is a lithium battery, 120 watt, and capacity is 25 ampere hour. This battery is able to work in the temperature from minus 20 to 40 Celsius degrees. There is a controller that can be adjusted from a smartphone, and you can choose there what you need more, power or range. The weight of the electric version is 120 kilos, so it weighs the same as regular version. The motor is mounted right here, you can see it now. This is the point of the central axle of the motor. Then there is a belt drive, which provides traction further to a chain drive and to the wheel. So this is a whole transmission, pure and simple. As a result, we have a transport with some significant advantages. It's almost noiseless but powerful bike, which always surprises everyone who sees it. We get used that enduro bikes are always very loud, and when somebody meets this bike for the first time, he gets completely confused why it's so quiet but very powerful. The other advantages are: needs no fuel, oil and other liquids, no exhaust, eco-friendly, little maintenance required. It's turned out to be a durable gadget, it isn't afraid of water, sand and mud. The product life here is only confined by the life of a battery. The motor is very durable and heavy duty, so it's almost impossible to break it. So, as we have mentioned, it needs almost no maintenance, unlike a standard gasoline bike. Of course, there are some drawbacks in comparison with the gasoline bikes. The most important, it's limited range. Use your own judgment. This version is able to go within 70 km or about 40 minutes of riding. But such result is for a sport mode. With the maximum load for a motor and the battery, the complete charging takes about 2 hours. Then we should remember that it's possible to install a more expensive and powerful battery and increase the range. By the way, I should mention that if you haven't tried such electric transport before, you will be greatly impressed. It differs from a gasoline version so much. Why? There is no gearbox, no any clutch. You may think only about acceleration and slowing down. Only use speed and electric power. Well, it's high time to try it myself, and I should say it's always my favorite part of any hour video. The few things that impressed me, how this bike reacts on a throttle. Just steer it slightly, and the bike speeds up extremely quickly. I was so delighted with the electric drive. It's hard to explain this quite smooth power, it's better to try it yourself, be sure, it's worth of it. The matter is, it starts accelerating without any little delay, unlike gasoline engines. When you are riding this bike, you are focusing only on the road, you don't need to select gears and control the clutch. No, just the road, the bike and the smooth power of the electricity. Well, it's okay, but we strengthened the leash to compare it with the regular bikes. Let's see how they are speeding up. Our bike is on the foreground. And as you can see, it doesn't concede the others at all. Then one of the riders decided to try it himself. You can see him on our bike in a red cap. By the way, this race took place at the end of the day, so the battery was rather low, but the electric bike at least wasn't worse than all the other gasoline bikes. Well, I think our bike performed quite well in comparison with gasoline, taking into account weak battery. As to the rear range, I should say that the battery provided us about 4 hours of intensive riding, so that is not bad. And remember that the battery easily can be changed for an even better one. As to the prices, well, if you decide to convert your bike to the electric version, it will cost you about $3,000 or $4,000. Worth of it? Use your own judgment, as to me I really was impressed by this bike. Guys, and what do you think? Can we say that electric transport is our future? Or gasoline is still in power? Leave comments, it's so interesting to read your opinions. And now let's call it a day. Thanks for watching, guys. Please subscribe the channel if you like this video. It will be many more interesting materials here. Goodbye.